Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. Okay, I am going to do a part two of making embellishments, and I was thinking, how else could I make a dangle trim? And I'm short. These are my little scraps here. I am short this trim because I've already used what I allotted myself in the kit. But I was looking at these and I was thinking, if I could cut these in half, then that's two little dangles. I might be able to attach it here and turn this into a dangle trim. I've got plenty of this in my store if you are interested in buying this. And I don't have this trim in my store because this was one that I bought from a friend of mine. But you could probably find that online somewhere. I was thinking, what if I made some flowers? And I've already done that because you guys have seen me make rolled roses. So I made a few tiny rolled roses. There's only three there. I'm thinking I should make a couple more. So, where's my scissors? If you don't want to watch me make the rolled roses, you can fast forward, but for the newbies, they might not know how. So I'm gonna fold this in an angle, in a point, and then I'm gonna add just a tiny bit of glue here and just start twisting. And then I'm going to fold this piece back because it's too tall, so I want to make it shorter. I'm just going to fold it back. There, I don't know if you could see this black. And then I'm going to put glue on the bottom here and then roll. And as I roll, I'm going to twist my ribbon. So hold it and twist it and then just sit it down in the glue. Put a little bit of glue, hold it and twist it. And I've shown this many, many times on my channel, and there's many, many other ladies who have made this rolled rose. Oops, I just want to glue it down there. Okay, so there's a little tiny, well, it doesn't want to stay glued down. Be careful with hot glue. I'm just used to it for the new, why doesn't it want to stay down? For the new crafters, don't stick your hands in the glue like I do. I'm just, like I said, I'm just very used to it. And it doesn't burn me, but it will burn you if you're not used to it. Okay, so there's a little rolled rose. I'm going to do a couple more really fast. Just so I can, oh, come on. My fingers don't work sometimes. Twist. I've made so many of these rolled roses that hold on to that so it stays down. And I'm not looking up, I'm sorry, this time I'll look up and make sure, let me do it this way. Okay, I just want to twist it. Okay. Oh, this glue gun. It's all on my fingers. And then it's attaching itself to my flower. To get rid of glue strings, you can always turn on your heating gun. That's for the newbies. And it will melt away all these little flyaway glue strings. I have quite a few new subscribers. Welcome. I hope you find interesting things in my channel or on my channel. There's another flower. Okay, so I've got about 6 little flowers there. I might need one more, but we'll see. And then I'm gonna just, maybe I'll do one more. Sorry. I just want to make sure I've got enough. I won't have to stop in the middle. Of my idea. Okay. Oh. My fingers are melting the glue gun. I mean the glue strings. Okay, I just want to hold it down. My glue strings all over my fingertips, my nails. Oh, come on, get out of there. Okay. And then on black, the glue dries white. So you can always take your glue gun and just hit the glue with your gun and it will melt that glue away. And then you won't have white spots anymore. Like, see that little white spot there? Now clean. Okay. So we've got lots and lots of flowers. And I'm just gonna, I got my piece of lace that I'm just gonna, I fold it in half and I'm just gonna put a tiny bit of glue. Just so that it's a double layer. Okay, and then I want to get this trim, and I'm going to cut it down the middle. Let's see. See these two? I'm just going to go right up the middle there. And then I'm going to separate this one. So I have all individual dangles. And then I had this little piece here also. Okay, so how many do I have? 7 flowers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 7. Let me move you down a little bit so you can see a little better. Okay, I'm all the way up. Okay. And do I have 7 of these? So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, I have an extra 7. So maybe I'll use that for something else. Okay. I think I like that. I think that's going to be a pretty trim. So I'm going to cut this. I want to make it flat. And then I want it, oh goodness gracious. And then I want to, it fell on the floor, just a sec. Glue it to my project. Like that. And I'm gonna cut that base off. Add glue so that it's flat. And glue it down. Now I've got the little extra piece there. Make sure it's flat. Nice, nice. Almost done. I'm making sure to glue it, the rose right on top. Oh, darn strings. Okay. I think that's good. So now I have a really pretty dangle trim. Super pretty. Of course, I have lots of fibers. Of course, I could add fibers. You know, between, really, you could, it's endless what you could do. But for now, I'm going to leave that trim like that. And add it to my embellishments here. Nice. Very, very nice. Why isn't that straight? Okay, yeah. Okay, I hope you liked this really quickie tutorial. And I'll be back with more. I think I'm gonna do page 5 next. So stay tuned. I'm still busy making a few of these little embellishments. And then at least I'll have a little box full of little flowers that I'm making. Rolled roses, all different kinds of rolled roses, all the fabrics that are in the kit. And, oh, I wanted to show you the leaves. Let me do that. I'm making leaves. Super simple. I've done fiber arts for a long time, so super pretty, huh? And really easy to do. Let me pull that out. Super, super pretty. So, how to do the leaves. I think you're going to get a piece of this green fabric in the kit. So, I'm cutting like about an inch. This is all rolled up, the fabric. So you have like a strip. And my famous knots. I like to tie a knot and leave as however big I want my leaf. And then just cut. And then tie another knot. And cut. Okay, so you can go through and do the whole. This is like t-shirt material. So it's not gonna fray. I'm leaving this about an inch, and then I'm cutting right underneath the knot. Okay, and one last one. Might be too short. Might be, no, I think I got it. Okay, good. So then now, all you have to do is open this up. You know, fold it in half, get your ends together. And just cut in a leaf shape. And then when it opens, you've got your leaf. You can put it this way or this way. Behind your flower. And you just glue it on. Super sweet, huh? So I made a bunch of those. Let's go ahead and do that again. Now that you have your little fabric, you could do these with lace. You can do them with satin. Just cut it in a leaf shape. There you have your little leaf. Okay. So I hope you've enjoyed these little embellishment tips. I'm going to go ahead and continue making a few other embellishments. Like I said, that way I can have them ready and available when I need them. I don't have to make the video so long while I'm making these embellishments. That's what takes the longest, is when I start making the embellishments. So, okay. I will let you all go and stay tuned for my page 5 of my Gypsy book. I am going to be starting it real soon. Thank you everyone for watching. And God bless. Bye.